Ah, oh, blessed be the name of the Lord, guys. I hope you guys had a wonderful Sabbath yesterday. I did. I enjoyed watching some things I needed to watch and just having a wonderful rest time with the Lord and my husband. I'm here today to do a video, guys. I was praying today and woke up, and the Father gave me a message to give you guys, coming from James 4. So we're going to be going over James 4 today. I never get James 4. I never even get James. I thought it was really amazing. He gave me James 4. So we're going to do James 4 today, and we're going to get into some other news. Iran news, Lewiston, Florida, BP Earthwatch talking about California, situation in California. I think I'm going to show Dutch Sense a little bit today. He's talking about the earthquake. I was talking to my subscriber over in Oklahoma area, and she was telling me they felt the quake shake the bed and shake the house, and she really felt it strong. So I'm going to be letting Dutch Sense talk about that. It's a two-day ago video, but it's got an update on it. I'm sure he did an update to give you guys some ideas of what's going to be happening in a few days. California been going through a lot of flood and waters and rain. And so we're going to talk about those things, and we're going to get into Bob a little bit. He's talking about the eclipse coming. So I'm going to be letting him talk a little bit about that. And then we're going to get into the Bible and missions report. I have some fresh pictures coming from Kenya. I'm probably going to show you some pictures of that. My missionary Godfrey just visited yesterday and took some Bibles over to our area. Met a pastor and gave out books and Bibles, and had a wonderful time. So I'm going to be sharing a little bit of that too. So we got a lot of things going on in the world, but we have to know that Yeshua have overcome the world. He has overcome the world, guys. Oh, I was listening to my friend yesterday talk about that. Mariel TV has a wonderful video on the end times, the signs of Christ coming back. And I did part one yesterday. I'm waiting for part two. I'm telling you should watch it, because he's giving them Bible scriptures. He goes all throughout the Bible, and it was really wonderful to see. So I hope I will put the first one in the description box, guys, for you guys to go watch. And this video today gonna be just getting through what's going on right now in the Bible and missions. Not going to be too long of a video today, but I hope you guys are having a wonderful Sunday. So let me go ahead and get started here. Buy my ebook titled He Did What from Amazon.com, Apple, Google, Kobo.com, Barnes & Noble. The link is on the screen. If you want the hardback, you can write me not too many pages about my life when I was from 16 years up. From 16 years old to my 60s, just a few little wonderful testimonies and miracles that God did in my life. I wanted to share it with my subscribers and people around the world. So if you want to get a copy, you want to get the ebook, you can go to Amazon there, and there's links above. And this is the ISBN number here. And the ebook is not but $2.99, but I do ask for a donation for the hardback if you want to contribute to help with missions and ministries and things like that, and orphans and homeless people. So it should be listed for $2.99, though, the ebook. Okay. So click subscribe, the like bell, subscribe to our YouTube channel, click the like button, click the notification bell. Fair use notice is in front of you. Title 17, disclaimer, and FBI notice. I am just excited today, guys. I am so excited. You know, when Yeshua talked to me in the morning and tell me things, he even gave me a Maranatha message today. We're going to be talking about in the dens and the caves of the earth. You know, he said that they will come and say, hide me from this man. Hide me. You know, those days are about to come, guys. We need to be getting ready. So let's go ahead and hear my wonderful song from Paul Weber. Love him so much. Look at his family on Sabbath. If you ever looked at his Sabbath program on Friday night and into Sabbath, it's a wonderful program of his family doing Sabbath at home. So let's go ahead and get started here with his song here. I love so much. This song went 10 years ago or more, but I love this song so much. So let's play it right now and get into today's video. So let me go ahead and mute out now.
Lost are saved, find their way at the sound of your great name. All condemned, feel no shame at the sound of your great name. Every fear has no at the sound of your great name. The enemy, he has to leave at the sound of your great name. Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us. Son of God and man, you are high and lifted up, and all the world will praise your grace.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, guys. Nobody like him. Nobody like him. If you haven't received Jesus today, Yeshua today, for your personal Savior, it's time to get on board, guys. It's time to get on board. So let me go ahead and get started here with the other news.
Mm-hmm. name is Lewis, and God bless every single one of you. Today is February 4th, 2024, and welcome to the Grand Supreme News Channel. Alright guys, so we have some urgent information coming out. If you can, please share this video. And it says here, Iran issued a warning Sunday, February 4th, to the U.S. over potentially targeting two cargo ships in the Mideast, long suspected of serving as forwarding operating bases for Persia commanders. All right, so we're gonna see what's going on here. Once again, the warning came just after the US and the UK launched a massive operation against Yemen, and that was yesterday. Today there is another operation going on, another airstrike. Took place today. So we're going to see what's going on here, guys. Once again, Persia is telling the sleeping giant, be careful. We see you and we're sending you a message. And this here got to be their third message already in the past 2 days. All right, guys, before I start, get this video.
Breaking emergency news, an executive order was just signed, and we also have a nationwide alert, a nationwide warning for major attacks on our U.S. critical infrastructure, right? This also comes as right now, multiple states are being hit by these attacks right now, right? This is happening in live time, multiple different states. They're having to shut down their systems and take their systems offline. Hospitals, voting systems, all right, all these things are being hit today and are being affected right now as well. All right, so our country is experiencing this. There's also a lot of news coming out from overseas, right? The US has launched a barrage of attacks, and we will talk about that later as well. All right, there's also nationwide phone outages being reported, all right? So all these things are hitting our country. These are happening in coordination, right? There's escalations happening overseas. And then we're also seeing these domestic cyber events taking our critical infrastructure offline and affecting it, right? In multiple different states right now. And there's a nationwide federal alert warning that's being issued as well. All right, so let's get into all this news. Let's get to these few states that are being hit, and then we will get into this executive order that was just signed as well, and then we will get into this nationwide alert, and then we will also talk about what is going on overseas. All right, but you can see here, all right, multiple different states are being hit right now and taking their critical infrastructure offline due to cyber attacks. All right, so this is happening in Tennessee right now. Okay, this is also happening in Georgia, and this is also happening in Texas and Illinois. All right, multiple different states are taking their critical infrastructure offline because they're experiencing these attacks. All right, and this is part of the warning, the nationwide warning that has also just been issued as well, that we could see big attacks, especially on our water supply. We could see the water shut down, right? Or the water contaminated or poisoned in these local jurisdictions where you get city water to your house, right? If you have a well, the electricity could go off though. All right, so let's get into these four different states, and then we will get to this executive order that was just signed as well, because this is all related. Things are escalating, right? The border is wide open while this is happening as well. And also our cybersecurity defenses are wide open.
Hey there. Did you know there's a simple activity that you're already...
And our country is being shut down and systematically being taken offline. Hospitals, voting systems, citywide servers, right? All these things are being taken offline right now. You can see here just this week, there have been two major hospitals inside of Chicago that have taken their systems offline, right? Two massive hospitals that are now unable to process people that are coming into the ER. They cannot access their systems. They cannot access the medical records. They cannot email or communicate with any other doctors or internally within the staff, right? This affects medication being delivered. All these things are being affected right now. Surgeries are being shut down because of this massive cyber attack on multiple hospital servers inside of Chicago. And this is exactly what would happen before a SHTF scenario inside the US, is that the hospitals would be taken offline first. So there's no way to respond to the event. All right, this is exactly what would happen. We would have a mass blackout and mass taking offline of our hospitals, so they couldn't communicate with each other and they were incapacitated. All right, but you can see here two hospitals just this week, all right, taken offline from cyber attacks. It was Lurie Children's Hospital, one of the biggest children's healthcare organizations in the Midwest, serving 239,000 children each year. On Thursday evening, the hospital reported a recent network outage due to a cyber attack. All right. It says Lurie's Children Hospital is actively reporting a cybersecurity matter. Quote, we are taking this very seriously and are investigating with the support of leading experts and are working with law enforcement agencies. They said, quote, as part of our responses to this matter, we have taken network systems offline. As Illinois' leading provider for pediatric care, our overarching priority is for safety and quality for the patients and the community. Also, St. Anthony's Hospital inside of Chicago as well, they said that external forces, potentially foreign governments, they are even saying, access their internal servers and were able to take them over. All right, this is happening also inside of Texas right now. All right, there is school districts inside of Texas that are reporting a nationwide outage of their phone provider. They're saying that they had to completely install new phones inside of their district, inside of the Beaumont Independent School District in Texas, due to a major cyber attack and a nationwide phone outage of their service provider. All right, we also have in Fulton County, Georgia, all right, very controversial county, right? We've seen a lot of stuff going on there, a lot of news coming out of Fulton, and now some even stranger news, all right? You see here, Fulton County locks down voting systems after cyber attack hits government, right? Quote, abundance of caution. You can see here, the weekend cyber attack hit its phones, courts, and tax systems, and they took the voting systems offline to make sure they're not going to be hit, all right? So this is almost just like foreshadowing what could come next. Just very strange. It seems like a foreshadow, okay? They're taking off the voting systems offline due to a cyber attack in Fulton County, Georgia, right now, preemptively in an election year in 2024, all right? So all this stuff, we're looking at something big to potentially happen in 2024 that could potentially affect things going on in November later this year. All right, let's hope that doesn't happen, but it seems like the narrative is being set up for something to potentially happen. All right, maybe things have to be suspended, maybe things have to be delayed. Who knows what's going to happen later this year, all right? But it seems like they're potentially setting this narrative up. We also have the FBI is joining investigations into the city of Germantown cyber attack in Tennessee. This is outside of Memphis, Tennessee, Germantown. And they're saying the FBI is helping to track down the people responsible for a cyber attack that caused the city of Germantown systems to be taken offline on Friday. All right, so all these different cities around the country, hospitals, critical services are being hit and taken offline at the same time. And this is a constant barrage, especially the past year or two. These things have ramped up exponentially, the amount of these attacks on our critical resources and infrastructure has increased tenfold, a hundredfold. And this is related to the executive order that was just signed right now and related to these sanctions that were just put in place as well, and this nationwide alert that was just issued by the federal government that our critical infrastructure is not safe, right? You can see here, U.S. imposes sanctions on Iranian officials over cyber attacks on water plants. It says the U.S. has imposed sanctions on six officials in Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, which says are responsible for cyber attacks on American water plants late last year. All right, so there were multiple dozens of water systems in the U.S. and multiple states that were taken offline due to this massive cyber attack all at the same time, all within a week of each other, dozens of systems taken offline. And this was a dry run. This was a dry run for something bigger to happen in the U.S. And we also have a nationwide alert being issued and warning being issued by CISA, the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency. They are now issuing a new alert by the Executive Assistant Director of the agency. The U.S. Cybersecurity Agency calls America's water systems that residents rely on to drink clean water, quote, target rich and cyber poor. Quote, it's why CISA moves with such urgency, said the agency's Executive Assistant Director for Cybersecurity, Eric Goldstein, in an interview with the BBC. He said there could be, quote, a hypothetical scenario where the cyber attacks had life safety impact and affected the potability of water. Quote, Iranian cyber actors continue to mature and invest in their capabilities. China is the pacing threat that the U.S. faces in cyberspace. There is malicious Russian activity, but North Korea and Iran could continue to invest in their capabilities. That is what he told the BBC, all right? So this warning was just issued, all right? This executive order was just signed for these sanctions on Iranian officials. And this comes at the same time that we are seeing escalations and retaliations in this part of the world as well, in the Middle East. Right now, there's a massive bombing campaign going on that just started tonight as well, right? From the U.S. going on inside of Iraq and Syria. Okay, so all these things are related. All these things are related, and we could see these escalations happen inside the U.S. domestically as well. Just because stuff's going on overseas doesn't mean we are safe here anymore, right? That's not the situation currently. And we could see things escalate inside the U.S. domestically. And if these attacks are successful, and if we see a major retaliation like this, we could see even bigger domestic kinetic warfare launched on the U.S. as well in the aftermath of a major cyber attack, a major blackout, whatever the case that happens, because there would be no way to respond. Right, the U.S. military uses the same systems, the same power companies, and the same water systems that the general public uses. These military bases use all the same resources that we use, and it's a security risk, right? And these things are all connected to the internet. So we also see right now that's happening tonight, right? This is why this warning is urgent and critical, because we could see responses happen, because the U.S. just dropped, quote, 125 bombs on 85 targets linked to, quote, Iran's Revolutionary Guard and devastating airstrikes on Iraq and Syria. All right, that is the article that is coming out tonight. And it says that multiple long-range bombers and drones hit 85 targets with 125 bombs over 30 minutes in the widespread military operation on Friday night.
Here is what they don't want homeowners.
Guys, please share these videos today. Share this video today. Very important video. not only the stuff going around, but the messages that will be here today are very, very important ones. So please try to share this video. I'm going to get on over to the other news. We're going to get into BP Earthwatch, Lewis, and I think BP Earthwatch Dutch Sense. And then I'm going to get into missions in the Bible. I think I did add Edward. I brought him back on because the other day we had to edit him out because I didn't do something right or something. But anyway, I'm going to play him again today, and we're going to get into missions in the Bible. So I'm telling you guys, we are in important, serious times. A lot of people like to say that, you know. I hear people say that all the time. Well, that's happening over there. It's not happening over here. Well, you know what? It's going to be happening here, and it is starting to happen here. We need to know we are in war. We are at wartime, guys. Wartime, okay? Not party time. Wartime. And we're going to be having all kind of things escalate in this country because of what's going on in the Middle East. And what I told you the other day on my last video in Daniel 8, all the things happening, all the things going to be happening. So we need to be understanding to prepare, stay prepared, be prayed up, and make sure your sins won't find you out, and repent, repent, repent. So I'm going to go on here now and get into the other news.
Guys, you're looking at satellite images that are current now as of 12:08 Central Time here in the U.S., and we've still got trouble on both coasts. Florida, now it's starting to get better. A lot of the storm line you're seeing is moving offshore. Now, from central Florida down further south, there's still some tornado watches, but it's not covering the entire southern part of the state right now. But California, you've got a system setting off there that's going to push into San Francisco Bay, and they just issued hurricane force wind warnings. Let's take a look at that. And just quickly, let's look at where the storms are. Your orange areas, yellow up into the oranges, that's where your heaviest moisture is. So again, Florida, you're starting to see somewhat of a break here, but it is moving up through Georgia, and it's crazy how this weather changes so quickly in this direction, but in the opposite direction. We just got through seeing two major dips in the Arctic vortex and bringing all that cold wind with it, but now everything's moving the opposite direction. California, again, you're getting pounded by this atmospheric river they're talking about, and they're saying it's going to be worse than the ones that you've had so far. Ground's already saturated. But they've just issued for the San Francisco Bay Area a hurricane force wind warning for this afternoon going into tonight. And it's going to get windy across the nation, guys. Here in the south, we're going to have wind gusts 25 to 40 miles per hour, but not like it is in California. You're throwing moisture in, rain. Again, Oroville Dam is being drained. They're watching all the reservoirs there. Someone mentioned that it should help Lake Mead, and that more than likely will happen. That's a good thing. But when you're dealing with 70-mile-per-hour wind gust, you're going to have a lot of problems with power lines and things like that. And with that, you've got moisture in the mountains that's turning into snow. You've got winter weather warnings, things like that. Let's take a look at that warning map. And this is what we have. Again, you've got just east and southeast of Lake Okeechobee offshore, still a tornado watch. And you've got marine warnings in this area, gale force wind warnings there and throughout the Gulf. Now, right here, you've got storm warnings all up and down the California coast. But right in the center, just south of the San Francisco Bay in the Monterey, California area, you have hurricane force wind warnings. That's powerful winds, 70 mile per hour plus, and that's going to do damage to trees, power lines. With this much moisture that you're getting in there, guys, you're going to have so much trouble between the flooding, the landslides, and now hurricane force winds. Now, this is coming out of San Francisco, and it's the National Weather Service. First thing right off the bat, all mariners need to be ashore. You do not need to be involved with hurricane force winds in the Pacific Ocean. It says hurricane force wind warning now in effect until 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time this afternoon. The storm warning now in effect from 3 p.m. this afternoon to 3 a.m. tomorrow morning. And what they're doing is the warning's up for hurricane force wind warning South winds 35 to 45 knots with gusts up to 70 knots and seas 19 to 23 feet. For the storm warning, southwest winds 30 to 40 knots with gusts up to 60 knots and seas 17 to 22 feet. So this is really, if you're talking about 60 miles or 60 knot winds going till 3 o'clock in the morning, it's going to be something that you're going to have to pay attention to for about 12 hours. It says the impacts, it will be extremely strong winds will cause hazardous seas, which will likely capsize or damage vessels and severely reduce visibility. Mariners should remain in port, alter course, and or secure the vessel for extreme conditions. Now, it looks like they're saying that the coastal waters from Point Pinos to Point Piedras Blancas in California are out 10 nautical miles. That's where you're dealing with. Now, I know I didn't pronounce all of those places right, but Point Pinos to Point Piedras Blancas, California, out 10 nautical miles. So anywhere in that area is going to be dangerous. But guys, if we'll go back and look at the actual satellite images over that part of the Pacific, and we'll get a better idea of what we're dealing with. And here's your problem. It's this low pressure system spinning counterclockwise, just like a hurricane. One thing I can say about it is it looks like the eastern section or the right half of the low pressure is drier. So that may give you a break in some of this moisture. You're already completely inundated in many areas, and the flooding is going to continue, especially here coming into the southern half of California. But this system right here, again, the 70 mile per hour or 70 knot winds that are isolated inside here will be getting there very quickly within 4 to 5 hours. I know you're already getting pretty good gust up into the bays. And guys, just like in any hurricane, and I've never really talked about this in San Francisco Bay, but when you push that much water into it, it can become very dangerous, just like it would up into Tampa Bay or something like that right there. And so this is what you're going to be dealing with. The only bright section of it, again, is it is possibly going to give you some break in the rain. But as it wraps up, it may pull that moisture in right behind it and kind of build it back up, guys. So just pay attention to it. It's not every day that I report on that type wind on the West Coast. Now, we saw it in Southern California back during hurricane season. Remember the one that came up through the Baja? You're dealing with much different coastlines here, and you're talking about 20 foot plus waves in many areas, and you push that into the bay, then you're going to have to be very careful. 70 knot winds, guys, I don't know, but let us know in the comments if you're from that area. This is going to affect a lot of the places there, but going across the Golden Gate Bridge, for instance, will they close that off? Because it would be very dangerous, especially for any vehicle like an 18-wheeler, something that has a lot of wind shear involved with them. So just pay attention to that if you're going to be out and about in California in that section today. Be careful of what you're dealing with. We're watching it, guys. You watch it. It's a heads up. Be safe.
Let's just get the show on the road. All right, let's just start over from the start. Here we are. It is 11:54 p.m. Central Time on the 2nd of February 2024. Still Friday night here in the U.S., going over into Saturday morning. Got some breaking news for everybody. A very large earthquake for the area has struck in the central United States in Oklahoma. And this brings us in next to...
There's one simple vision hack anyone can use to improve vision, so you can say goodbye to your optometrist for good.
Some pumping operations back in Prague, Oklahoma. Let's get the page open here from the USGS. You can see on the screen 5.1, biggest in years for the state. Let's go put the coordinates in. Let's go over to Google Earth and see what's at the epicenter. I already know what's around Prague. This gets into the drill points, the oil and gas drill points. that are all around the region. So we're not just talking about in Prague, but around Prague. Let's see if we can find a nearby drill point to show you an example of one. I don't have any marked here on the screen, but we should be able to just kind of go down the road. There we go. There we go. This is just a nearby set of wells. Again, we've got fracking going on here, which is actually wastewater disposal. They'll take chemicals and mix it with fresh water, put it down into the ground, which then breaks apart the shale. They'll then drill in and get oil and gas out of old wells that were already drilled a long time ago. Here's another one right here, more of an example of an older well. Let me make sure you guys can see this. So the tanks sometimes store chemicals that they then mix with fresh water and put down into the ground. Other times they'll use those tanks for storage too. Okay, now let's turn on our borders and labels just so we can see our general area around. Here's Oklahoma, central Oklahoma. It was likely felt all the way as far east, northeast as Tulsa, and probably as west, far west, southwest as the border down by Wichita Falls down to Texas. Again, when you get a five in here, usually a few hundred miles out from the epicenter, you can feel that at least a little bit of shaking. People might think it's something else going on, but I mean, here's 100 miles. 100 miles takes us over to the border this way, 120. 100 miles takes us down, again, down south of the border, 100 miles that way. So just a perspective for where you might expect to be actually feeling this. That's a big earthquake for the area, and it's directly next to drill points. So a lot of people are probably wondering, where did it come from? Well, how about the 5.1 that struck off the coast earlier today, over off the west coast? You see, it's a 4.9 now, but regardless, whether it's 4.9 or a 5.1, it's the same size quake that struck all the way over here off the west coast of California. And to show that to you, let me take you back to the USGS plate boundary map that I show in most of my updates regularly. So over here on the west coast, you'll see there's some red lines, and they come together right there at the northwest part of California and then goes down the San Andreas. That's the plate boundary for the Pacific. The red lines are the plate boundaries that define areas between plates. Earlier today, a 5 struck off the coast here. Now, when 5s strike off the coast here, we tend to see a corresponding effect across the plate within days about the same sized earthquakes. Go over to the Midwest and even sometimes as far east as the East Coast and Northeast. This gets me into this, which I show all the time. And you can see our arrow, this graphic has existed for 9 years or 10 years ago. I made this graphic in particular for the Craton. But notice where the arrow is over Northern California. And it points over to what? Points over to the Craton edge, which goes down through Texas and then back up through Oklahoma and the East Coast. Remember that Craton diagram, because now look at the earthquakes over the last day. So we're going to turn off our actual numbers just so you can see where the earthquake struck. So we get a 5 off the coast earlier today. Then, throughout the day, we see a stepping stone path of the same sized earthquakes, all 2s and 3s, leading across southern Utah, down through Texas, and up to the spot that just got hit. So in other words, we go from here, over to here, back up to here. And we should see this spread all the way up the East Coast. We should see a significant increase in seismic activity over the next several days over on the East Coast, as well as the mystery booms and rumbles that they always try to blame on sonic boom from aircraft, and they'll blame it on everything except for the plate shifting, because they do not want to admit the plate is shifting from the west coast to the east coast, because that contradicts the whole mid-Atlantic ridge spreading and pushing the whole continent to the west. Anyway, the seismic flow, the earthquake flow, goes from over on the west coast over to the east coast, regardless of which way the plate's moving at the surface. Down below, the seismic flow goes from west to east. So, yet once again, we see the same sized earthquake off the west coast, then followed by activity over in Oklahoma. This has happened several times. The last time the biggest earthquake struck in Oklahoma, again, this goes back several years, but the last time this happened, we saw the same sized earthquake off the west coast first. I've told you guys to watch for this for 10 freaking years at this point. That's your teacher swearing. Is freaking a swear word? Okay. Let's also talk about the Northeast being hit yesterday. 3.2 to 3.3 struck right north of, well, actually on the southeast side of Quebec, Ontario border, or just north of the U.S. border. That's right next to New Hampshire and Vermont. So let's recap. a significant sized earthquake has struck in central Oklahoma next to drill points. Now, this is struck because a wave is going across North America. It's not just this spot being struck. It's that there's a seismic wave that's going across North America. It's being dropped off along the way at drill points. Also, you could go over on the West Coast. Let's go back to the USGS graphic over here. The reason that it was struck over here along the coast, plate boundary. Plate boundary struck here, drill point struck here. I'd expect in the far northeast, we should also see a connection of earthquakes going across the south down through Mississippi, Alabama. The pumping operations there should light up. We may even see rare activity in Michigan or up in the Great Lakes next to the drill points up there and the power generation stations along the Great Lakes there. I don't know which to tell you to watch other than we would watch at Ohio border mainly and then possibly as far north as like Detroit or northeast of Detroit. We've seen this happen many, many times. Significant activity off the West Coast, followed by significant activity in the Midwest, followed by significant activity on the East Coast. The local
states are the red states, you know, the problem states for the Biden administration. All the red states are taking their personnel, sending it into one convenient location, their state guard to Texas. Okay. Imagine if they just wanted to just bomb it right there. All the state guards conveniently in one location, just drop a big bomb or even a nuke, take care of all that and get this party started. Conveniently in one location, just drop a big bomb or even a nuke, take care of all that and get this party started.
If you want to fight against the country, you need an F-15.
If we have to send F-15s to Texas here and wage war against Texas, and so be it.
Not enough time.
The word is there right now. You can enjoy the word. Which verse says it? There will be a great famine of the word. Now it's available, but there is no time to put pretty flowers around the gospel. If we can get the verse on the screen, there you go. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst of water, but of hearing the words of the Lord. And this is okay. You people will say, hey Frenchie, you're not in the right dispensation and this and that, but it's still there. The old Bible was written for you and the old Bible was not written to you. Okay, so there's differences. I understand that, but it's still there. Like Bob was talking about the land mourn, that's Hosea 4:3. The land is mourning right now. So there is no more time with everything, all the topics that we talked about tonight, the word that you hear about the gospel tonight might be your last chance. So make the right decision. I don't know how people see what's coming up. How do you see that, Brother Tom? How do you see the things coming up right now? Just physically, not regarding the Bible, but just physically. Do you think we live in a beautiful, nice and pretty flower world?
I keep saying I think the beauty of living through these very, very dark times is that gospel message shines brighter every single Amen. Day. You know, every day I'll go, you know, I spend 2 to 3 hours preparing for my videos every day. And every day I look at the darkness in this world and I think, Lord, give me an opportunity to not just soak into this darkness. Let me show them the darkness and then show them how bright you are in these times.
Amen.
Because that message is getting brighter and brighter. And when I share the gospel and I share it every day, and it's not, you know, sometimes I bet you there's a small handful of people that don't know the Lord. Like in this chat, I bet you 99% of these people are saved. But you know what? I need to hear the gospel every single day. I need to hear it every day. And the darker this world gets, Amen. The more I cling to the good news that Amen. Jesus paid for my sins with his blood.
Yes.
Yes. You know, that's the most intense words that I can say, and the simplest way. He paid for our sins with his blood. Yes. The one who spoke and nothing became everything went to a cross for us. And that's just, you know, so I don't care how dark the world gets. My Savior is getting brighter every single
Amen.
Day.
And Amen. That, and the road, right, on that yes. journey. And just like, guys, we were created by him, and he formed us from the ground, right? The delicacy that he took and breathed into Adam, right? His nostrils, the breath of life. We are still his workmanship, right? So yeah. we still see that typology and that picture being illustrated further. And to know that God is the head of all things, completely sovereign and control over our salvation, and has sealed us with his Holy Spirit of promise, Ephesians 1:13, Ephesians 4:30. It's such a blessing. And to know how dark the times are getting, one thing that I have noticed in my own personal walk with the Lord is there's not a lot of gray area anymore. It's either the brightness or the darkness.
You're right.
You know, it's very easy now to discern that path to the Lord and what the Lord has been doing in our lives and is calling us to do. It's much easier now to recognize the voice of the Lord in the situations that we're going through in our life right now because of that gross darkness that has come over the land. So, and on one side, it's terrifying, and sometimes it can be like, whoa, God, what's going on? But on the flip side, it's like, Lord, this is a blessing because now I know more of you than I probably ever would have known in any other circumstance. And God, right. nothing's by, you know, chance. There's no such thing as chance or randomness no. with God. I just don't believe that. And each and every single one of us, I know God had put into the loins of your father and planned that family tree out across all of creation and all of time, because he knew the beginning from the end. So it was no accident that you're here tonight, even listening to us here live on Uptown Community Church, or that Brother Tom's here. This was all God's will and how he's steering and directing us. Yeah. And I think that's really fascinating to sit back and think, God, you're amazing. You really are planning everything and ordering our steps through life. And God will give you experiences too, and to show you just how he really orders your steps. It's amazing, guys.
In the chat there that you just put up, the days of Noah are returning. Once the door will be shut, the rapture will be done, then it's gonna be so hard to believe, because there will be a lie that everybody is going to believe, and that's going to be such a disastrous thing, because people won't be able. I don't think it's going to be easy to be a Christian after that, to become a Christian, because if you're a Christian and truly Bible believer with the blood of Christ, you're already gone. But whatever comes after that, it's going to be such a chaos. It's going to be so hard that I don't understand how people will be living. And right now, Brother Tom was talking about the darkness of this world. Well, I think it's a full gambling to go through the darkness without the gospel. I think this is crazy. This is it's not crazy. Having Jesus Christ as your Savior. This is crazy. I mean, you're going through the darkness, and it's like you put all your bets on the black there. I don't gamble, but this is a gambling thing, I think. If you don't want to be with the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in the blood, because if you don't, I'm sorry, but there's a tremendous definition of the word lust, and it's incredible. One of my pastor once told me, he says, besides the fact that it's going to be physical to be in hell for those who goes there, it's going to be so hard physically, like the burning, the smell, the pain and the crying and everything. But the worst pain will be the spiritual one, knowing that the Lord Jesus Christ will never hear you anymore. Like the void of being, the hope will be gone. Now, even those who are not saved, if somebody is sick, they might get on their knees and pray the Lord for a salvation and stuff like this, which is great. But once you're there in hell, that's going to be done. no one's going to listen to you or hear you or hear your prayers or anything like this. It's going to be a void. And that's going to be tremendously painful, I think.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I once heard it said that you can go 30 days potentially without food. You can go potentially 3 days without water. You can potentially go a few minutes without breathing, but you can't go any time without hope. And I just, that crushes my heart to think about that situation. Because, as you know, if we're all honest, we've all been in parts in our life, we've experienced what hopelessness feels like. But because of the one we serve, God, King of the universe, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, he has given us a hope that no matter how bleak things get, we can fall on him. And I just don't, I constantly rack my mind. I'm like, God, I don't know how people get through this life without you. I don't know how they do it.
You know, Michael, and what you're saying is, you know, it's interesting to listen to you because you were talking earlier about the spiritual attacks and things you've been going through.
Yeah.
Pretty much everything that you've said this evening has been the Lord working in you to build you up to where you're going to be able to handle these spiritual attacks.
Mm-hmm.
But just being here tonight, he's energized you to share a lot of what many people need to hear, me included. This has been really good.
Hey family, let me show you really quick what we are doing right now to expand the body.
I'll put this in the description box. I can't do the whole video because it's 22 minutes, but they did put on the screen somebody talking about the eclipse coming up in April, but I thought they was going to talk about that. So maybe in the middle of the video, they get more into that. So go and listen to it. I'm going to get on over here now to missions. Edward got a fabulous message, man. I muted it out on the other video. I didn't get to play it because I had the sound on and it was real hard to hear. So I'm going to play it right now again from Edward. Then we're going to get into missions, some pictures and missions. And in the Bible here, I'm excited to talk about today from James 4. Okay, so let me do that now.
The Lord speaks as follows. February, a month of change.
February, a month of change. Patterns begin to form and become apparent. Take note of it.
A change in dispensation. This year marks the close of a dispensation. That means February closes a dispensation.
A change in dispensation means a change in how God deals with people.
I close this dispensation of plenty and open the doors of famine, pestilence, and war. Say it again, war, war, war. A change in the tone and character of your government.
Hear these words about your government. It is soon to change by turning against those who truly follow me. Those that serve the world will be distinguished from those that serve me. The great falling away is soon to manifest to the world. There will be a distinction. Chosen ones will be hated. Your government will soon restrict the liberties of my people. They will seek to quench the voice of my holy ones. They will seek to change what has been written by my own finger. Your government will soon restrict Christian broadcasting on all forms of media. I am removing those freedoms, says the Lord.
February ends in sorrow as losses mount.
Prepare, O saints, for mourning and weeping, for the fall of your nation has begun. Trouble is in your country, even at the door. Losses, many losses. Under this administration, the liberties of this people are curtailed. Battle signals begin.
My father speaks of the loss of livelihoods.
The Lord says this is the hour of trial. Many will see the loss of livelihoods as I drive them away from pride, as I remove the pride of their life.
The mouth of the Lord has spoken. Subduction zone, hot water rising.
Thus saith the Lord, once, twice, third time. See how I move the nations? Now I move upon your nation, America. You who dwell by many waters and are rich in treasure, your end has come and your ill-gotten gains are gone. Down with the gavel. Deceived. Seed time and harvest, summer and winter, gone. It's winter. No, it's summer. The seasons are messed up. When did this happen? The words of knowledge with that are polar flares, cosmic rain above the heavens, banks, floodplain, war.
The Lord says there is wickedness in the house of the king.
Danger and calamity is on this people next. It shall be in an instant and suddenly. Refining starts and there will be an onslaught of wickedness. It will be in the house of the king. I repeat, wickedness in the house of the king.
The leadership of this nation shall diminish. Leaders shall be exposed. Their nakedness shall be seen. Their wickedness shall be laid bare for all to see. Trust among the people shall diminish. Truth shall fall. Chaos will ensue. Civil unrest shall prevail throughout the year.
My son, you will see civil unrest, famine, and pestilence. Peace is now removed from my people.
Okay, days of Gibeah. Let's begin. We'll pick it up over here in Judges. In the days of Gibeah, there was no king in Israel. Everyone did what was right in his own eyes. So in ancient Israel, in the days when there was no king, the people became a law unto themselves.
No solution to find peace. Civil war. Signs in the heavens shall increase.
Watch the skies. Things in the sky appear to bring signs. There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars. This is the year for signs to testify.
Righteousness shall be mocked. Evil shall be exalted. It shall be celebrated. Perverted people shall be celebrated.
So let's jump over to Judges and start there. The old man picks them up. They are spending the evening at his house. As they were enjoying themselves, suddenly certain men of the city, perverted men, surrounded the house and beat on the door. They spoke to the master of the house, the old man, saying, "Bring out the man who came to your house, that we may know him."
Truth will be missing. The Lord says there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land. Therefore, I will change your glory to your shame, for the day of your visitation has come, and the day of recompense has arrived.
There's a nation that does not obey the voice of the Lord their God, nor receive correction. Truth has perished, has been cut off from their mouth. Their dwelling place is in the midst of deceit. They refuse to know me, says the Lord.
Whoever turns from evil is plundered and becomes prey for the wicked.
When someone turns to righteousness, he makes himself prey.
Okay, guys, I'm getting ready to show some pictures here from missions. My friend Gautry over in Kenya, he went out yesterday and he did some missions. And so we're going to go ahead and show a few pictures, and then I'm going to get into missions and we're going to talk about the Bible. Now, this is when he went up to Brother Peter's church over there in Kenya. Wonderful brothers in the Lord, wonderful pastor, And actually, Betty S., pastor over there in Kenya. And, you know, it was so wonderful to connect these brothers, man, because they have a lot in common, very powerful men of God. And so he went up to take some books, Bibles to the people there. Never had Bibles, can't afford Bibles. And you can see all the big congregation here at his church. They so excited to get a Bible, reading the Bibles as they get them. And the men got Bibles, and it's just wonderful, guys, wonderful. And this is Godfrey here, all excited. And I'm going to be showing a little clip coming from Pastor Peters. He's really got a heavy voice, too, because I can't hardly hear him on the microphone. But I'm going to play it anyway a little bit. This is him here. And so we just want you guys to know God is working. It's really time to do what we can, be about our Father's business. So let me go ahead and play that little clip here from Kenya when he went to the church there yesterday and gave out Bibles and things to the people there. So it's just a wonderful opportunity. Let me go ahead and mute it out because it's going to be loud anyway. Loud, he got a good voice.
We want to thank God because of our brother Bob of Feed My Sheep Day Ministry for giving us Bibles. As you can see in the background, people are very happy and are very jovial. Though we didn't get enough, we need more because some people have not gotten. But what we have received, we really thank God, and may God bless your ministry. May God bless America. May God bless Kenya. May God bless this community and this church. Hallelujah. We want to thank God because of our brother Bob of Feed My Sheep Day Ministry for giving us Bibles, as you can see in the find me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, guys, hallelujah. I don't know how to thank the Lord more and more every day. Like I tell people, if you want to pray once a week, go ahead and pray once a week, but it don't do much for us, guys. We got to pray every day, every day, every day, as their brothers were saying there on End Time Dream and Vision, Uptime. We need to pray every day. You need to talk to the Lord every day. You need to ask him what he got for you to do today. You need to thank him for getting up in the morning. You need to just praise him. Share a track, share a Bible, share some kind of truth with somebody. I was talking to my mom this morning about Daniel 8 and telling her all the things are happening, you know, as the Bible is talking about, as Charles Whelan was talking about, for he died. And, you know, we need to just talk to people. They don't might not agree with you. They might not want to hear it. But you need to sound the alarm, sound the alarm, sound the alarm, guys. Yeshua is coming soon, 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 soon. So let's get started here with James 4. I was excited this morning when the Lord gave me James 4. Really, I never went on it in a long time. But you see the title? Warning Against Worldliness. Warning Against Worldliness. You know, I was looking at the paper this week. All through the paper, nothing but drugs, 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 everywhere drugs, 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 again, getting arrested for drugs, getting arrested for drugs. It's just horrible what people, the devil is have done with drugs, got people all addicted to drugs. We need to be addicted to Yeshua, Messiah, Ahaya. We need to be telling him to fill us up with his Holy Spirit, his power, his might, his fire. Oh, that's what we need. We don't need drugs. We don't need alcohol. We don't need all these things, guys. A lot of people on fentanyl and heroin and dope and cocaine and you name it, meth, crystal meth, and it's just everywhere, in the cars, in the trucks, in the vans, in the sea, in the planes, in the airport. It's just horrible, horrible, horrible. So, Father, be with me now. We go to your wonderful chapter for the day, James 4. We'll ask that your Holy Spirit come be with us right now. Father, I'm on fire for you right now. Help my husband to read with fire. We need to read with fire today because this message is so important. We got to come out of the world. We're in the world, not of the world. He say, I have overcome the world. You know, we don't need to be in the world. Greater he that is in us than he that is in the world. So we need to understand how important it is to really preach right now and teach right now and tell your people, get ready, get ready, get ready. Jesus is coming. Yeshua is coming. Get ready, get ready. So let's go ahead and read now and let Jesus come and be with us. The Holy Spirit come be with us now as we read this word in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Go ahead.
Warning against worldliness.
As my friend Dr. Randy McLean like to say, go ahead.
James
4, okay, go ahead.
Start in verse 1. Where do quarrels and disputes among you come from? Do they not come from your desires that fight among your members? You desire and you do not have. You murder and covet and you are not able to obtain. You fight and quarrel. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask with wrong motives in order that you may use it for your sensual desires.
See, this chapter is what I read it today. Then you read it too. Then you get that out of that chapter. This chapter is about flesh. This chapter is about our wants, what we need, what we want, you know, it's not about loving Yeshua. It's about us. And that's what the world has become. It's about my drugs. It's about my alcohol. It's about my sex. It's about my wife. It's about my boyfriend. It's about whatever, you know, we want to just cling to this world. Yeshua said not to cling to this earth and its treasures. Don't cling to this world and its treasures. We need to come out of the world. Give up this world, guys. Give up Babylon. I'm telling you. Go ahead.
You adulteresses, do you not know that friendship with the world is hostility against Yahuwah? So whoever wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of Yahuwah.
Wow, how simple can that be? Go ahead.
Or do you think the scripture says in vain, the Ruach he caused to live in us is deeply jealous? But Yahuwah gives more grace. So the scripture says, Yahuwah opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So submit to Yahuwah, resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
Resist the devil, guys. We got to resist the devil. We got to resist going out with bad people. We got to resist going out with bad crowds. We got to resist eating things we shouldn't eat. We got to resist all these things that people are into. I can't believe so many people are addicted to all these drugs. It just really blow me away. We need to really resist these things. Run away from the devil. Flee from the devil. Go ahead.
Come close to Yahuwah, and he will come close to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, yeah. and purify your hearts, you double-minded.
It's double-minded. When we live for the world and live for God, we're trying to live for both. You can't serve two masters. You can't. And, you know, it's all of our life. My life, too. I have to struggle with it. I'm like, you know, the TV ain't going to be the first idol in my life. We have to know that Yeshua is the one that's important. We have to preach the gospel, talk to the missionaries, talk to others, pray for others, praying all the time, praying without ceasing, praying and not fainting. You know, it's time for us to know what's important, what's really important, not to be double-minded. Go ahead.
Grieve, mourn, and cry. Let your laughter turn into sadness yes. and your joy into gloom. Humble yourselves before Yahuwah, and he will lift you up. Do not speak against one another, allegiance. The person who speaks against an allegiant or judges his allegiant speaks against the law and judges the law. If you judge the law, you are not a doer of the law, but a judge.
Listen, we got to explain this to the people. And you know, I'm going to go over here now. It's James. I got it out of Amplified when I was reading it this morning. But let's go here to the other version. And let's pull that up in that verse. What is that, 11? 11. Okay, if you go to here, Amplified, it kind of explains it a little better, guys. It say, my brethren, do not speak evil about. Accuse one another, guys. He that maligns a brother, judges his brother, is maligning and criticizing the law and judging the law. But if you practice the law, you are not a practicer of the law, but a censor and judge of it. You know, and it's talk about down here, go ahead and finish it here in this other one. One only is the lawgiver. You know, Yeshua, Messiah, Ahaya, he is the lawgiver and the judge who's able to save and to destroy. Okay, the one who has the absolute power of life and death, absolutely. But you, who are you that you presume to pass judgment on your neighbor? And I'm just saying that is what that is talking about. So important, he wanted me guys to share with you guys. So many pastors, so many preachers, so many prophets and prophetesses or whatever, whoever they may be, they are judging. You know, I don't live home with you. I don't know what you do in your house. I don't know your heart. I don't know your mind. I don't know what you're thinking. Only Yeshua knows. That's why we need to pray for one another. You know, I don't ever want to see my children in hell. I don't want to ever see my neighbor in hell. I don't ever want to see my husband in hell or my mother in hell or nobody in hell. Hellfire is not, it's real, guys, real, okay? So we need to stop. We need to stop. Stop judging. Stop picking at one another. Stop accusing one another. Who are we? We are not to judge. We are not. Go ahead.
Now listen, you who say, today or tomorrow we will go into the city, spend a year there, trade, and make a profit. Mm-hmm. Who knows what will happen tomorrow, and what is your life? Mm-hmm. For you are a mist that appears for a little while and then disappears.
Really? We are not that we could be gone like that. We're gone like that. Why don't you give your life to him today if you haven't? You can be gone like that. You don't have to wake up tomorrow. You don't have to come back when you go out. You don't have to, guys. It's time to know who's in charge. Yeshua is in charge. He's the great king. He's the great Lord of lords. He's going to be the one that rules forever and forever. Why do you want to follow the devil? Why do you want to keep doing what the devil like you to do? It's time to repent. Go ahead.
Instead, you should say, if Yahuwah wills, we will live and do this or that. But now you are boasting about your arrogant plans. All such boasting is evil. So for anyone who knows to do good but does not do it, for him it is sin.
Oh, my goodness. See, people like to use that scripture. It's true. I hear people use that scripture, and they almost give people a hopeless situation, you know, because you think, well, I've sinned so many times, and I have no, the devil tell you, he beat you up. He tell you, oh, you have no hope. And Yeshua is the great hope. And he said, if you fall, get up again. I had to get up. A lot of times, even now, we have to still get up. We can't just let the devil take our salvation. We can't let the devil take our crown. We cannot allow him to do that. So you go to the Father and bow down to the Father and say, Father, here I am. I sinned today. I did this today. Please forgive me again, Father. Forgive me again. Strengthen me, Father. Strengthen me. Don't let the devil take your crown. Don't let him take your salvation, because he is nobody. He has no future. But Yeshua say we can have a future. He said, whosoever will, let him come. Okay. So you know we need to know to go to him, to go to him, guys. Don't let the devil tell you lies like that. Because if you are living, if you have breath to breathe, you have an opportunity to go to the kingdom. Go to the Father and say, Father, I want to be in your kingdom. Heal me. Help me, Father. I'm weak. Whatever you want to tell him, talk to him like you talk to anybody else. Let him know that you are the one that need him and want him, and you want to be in his kingdom. That's all. He will help you do it, guys. I just love talking to him in the morning. He said, Marnie, go and get James out. Go in, you know, I say, Father, you're such a wonderful God. Oh, you're my daughter. You're my daughter, he tell me. You know, you need to just have a relationship with him where he can talk to you, where he can show you things. This message we're going to do at the end, in the dens and the caves of the earth. He gave me that to give you guys, because they're going to be coming out saying, oh, hide us from him, hide him. Why would you want to hide from the master, the man who made you? You need to be giving your life to him today, guys. It's just simple. Don't you know he's alive? Don't you know he is? So you need to trust him and believe. Believe. Only those that believe, okay, will receive this kingdom. Only those that believe, they will receive it. So we're going to go on over here now and get into Maranatha. So the wonderful, wonderful scripture in the dens and the caves of the earth. Oh my goodness. So I'm going to go ahead and mute it out right now.
October 9. In the dens and caves of the earth, and they shall go into the holes of the rocks and into the caves of the earth for fear of the Lord and for the glory of his majesty when he ariseth to shake terribly the earth. Isaiah 2:19. The hidden ones have been scattered because of man's enmity against the law of Jehovah. They have been oppressed by all the powers of earth. They have been scattered in the dens and caves of the earth through the violence of their adversaries, because they are true and obedient to Jehovah's laws. But deliverance comes to the people of God. To their enemies, God will show himself a God of just retribution. From the dens and caves of the earth that have been the secret hiding places of God's people, they are called forth as his witnesses, true and faithful. The people who have braved out their rebellion will fulfill the description given in Revelation 6:15-17. In these very caves and dens, they find the very statement of truth in the letters and in the publications as witness against them. The shepherds who lead the sheep in false paths will hear the charge made against them. It was you who made light of truth. It was you who told us that God's law was abrogated, that it was a yoke of bondage. It was you who voiced the false doctrines when I was convicted that these Seventh-day Adventists had the truth. The blood of our souls is upon your priestly garments. Now will you pay the ransom for my soul? What shall we do who listened to your garbling of the scriptures and your turning into a lie the truth which, if obeyed, would have saved us? When Christ comes to take vengeance on those who have educated and trained the people to trample on God's Sabbath, to tear down his memorial and tread down with their feet the feed of his pastures, lamentations will be in vain. Those who trusted in the false shepherds had the word of God to search for themselves, and they find that God will judge every man who has had the truth and turned from the light, because it involves self-denial and the cross. Rocks and mountains cannot screen them from the indignation of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb.
Not only Seventh-day Adventists. It means people who believe in Yeshua Messiah, higher, following his commandments, keeping his commandments, honoring his feasts and things that he have told us to do. And I'm so proud of my brother over in Kenya. He's got a church going up. God has been supplying the need for that church to go up. He said people are lining up, signing up today because they want to keep Sabbath. They want to keep the real, true Sabbath, not Sunday, not Romanism, not Catholicism, not all these things that just Catholicism have taught people wrongly. You know, you need to be following the Lord and worshiping Him in spirit and in truth. As it says in Genesis to Revelation, we need to know it's line by line, precept by precept. Guys, it's time to follow Yeshua and keep His commandments and know that these things are coming. They are going to try to get us to bow down to Molech, bow down to the devil, bow down to the Antichrist system. Are you ready to stand for your God? Are you ready to stand for the man who made you? Are you really ready to do that? Are you ready to die for Him like He died for you? Are we ready, guys? We need to get ready. We need to get ready. The tribulation is really coming strong on this country. It's already about to happen, guys. Are you going to be ready? Are you going to be ready? So I hope you're going to be ready today. We're going to go ahead and end the video, but I really know that things about to happen. This country is in such a tension situation right now. It's just 11-11 moment, you know, all over the place. We can have anything happen. Bombs, missiles, earthquake, megaquakes, anything can happen right now with all the things going up, lining up in Iraq, Iran, over there in Gaza, and all the nations that I pray for every night, Israel, Damascus, Jordan, Jerusalem, all over there, guys. The hourglass is running. Time is running fast before us. We got all these people who wants to be our wonderful physicians, but the Bible says in Job 13:4, what? They are forgers of lies, and you are all physicians of no value, so you need to be putting your trust in Him, letting Him be your healer, your doctor, your lawyer, your whatever He can be, your friend, your companion, your husband, and your savior. You know, we need to give our life to Jesus Christ, Yeshua Messiah, higher today, guys. As the world out there, who many people don't have Bibles, they're just getting Bibles, don't have Bibles in foreign lands. A lot of them they never had a Bible. I love the testimony. I'm going to go say that testimony and let my husband pray. Remember the testimony I told you guys about Godfrey Still? I think it was him. The police had stopped him, and he needed, the police had stopped him. They locked him up, okay? And he go and talk to God and say, Father, what I'm going to do? You know, they're locking me up. And the Lord tell him to go and give the man a Bible. Give the man a Bible. So he go and give the man a Bible, and the man set him free. Let him go home. He never had a Bible, wanted a Bible. So this is what I mean. You know, we have to learn to listen to Yeshua. You know, whatever we get ourselves into, He will give you the answer. He will help you. And we got to stop doubting God. We just, so many of us doubting God all the time. And I'm just saying, stop doubting God. Let Him tell you what to do. He will show you the way. He will help you. He will help you walk the narrow pathway. He will get you out of your debt. He will get you out of your trouble. But you need to go to Him. Like He said in James 4. What He just said in James 4? You ask not because you have not. You ask not because you have not. I'm sorry. You have not because you ask not. We need to start asking. Start trusting. Start believing. As it says in the Bible, ask, seek, and knock. Those three things can't go wrong most of the time. Asking, seeking, knocking. But you know, a lot of times we sit on our duff and do nothing, and we doubt, and we let the devil beat us down to nothing. And we need to stop letting the devil beat you down. For you are born of Yeshua Messiah. You are born in His image. He made you very special. Even the fingernails on all your fingerprints are made different from anybody else's. Your hair on your head is numbered different from anybody else. Guys, come on. You know, who are you going to believe in today? Who are you going to trust today? Trust in Messiah Yeshua. I'm going to go ahead and let you close out with prayer, unless you got something to say. The closing. Yeah, the closing. Okay. All right, I could close out with prayer. That would be fine enough for me. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and close out with on the screen here. Guys, I tell you, this is one reason I wrote the book, really. And I didn't even think about it. I had this book written many years ago, and I kept everything in a journal. I told you guys to keep a journal of all the things God have done for you. And then when things get bad, you can go back and read your own little book, read your own little things that He have done for you, where you don't give up so easily, okay? So I wrote it in a little book, all my testimonies and a few miracles, and when the angel came to me and my husband, and a lot of wonderful testimonies in the book. So you can buy it. You can go and get the ebook for $2.99. And also go ahead, and we could go ahead and go down and download Gene's free e-Bible from lulu.com, kobo.com, smashwords.com, Scribd, and FMCMI. Download free at biblesupport.com and wordmodulars.com. And also the King James Version, you can download at the same locations. One modular is SOTV-KJV. One has the Apocrypha, SOTV-KJVA. Also, we really appreciate each and every one of you for your offerings to help the homeless, the orphans, the widows, and those in need in mission fields all over the world. May Yahuwah richly bless each and every one of you. Also, FMCMI alternative channels, rumble.com, BitChute, Facebook, FMCMI.org. Also, donate by Cash App, our cash tags there, and also other donation options, fmcmi.org, mona.campbell@gmail.com, and PayPal. Mail in your donations at Fill My Cup Ministries, Post Office Box 414, Canyon City, Colorado, 81215. Also, shipping address, Fill My Cup Ministries, 1501 Main Street, number 414, Canyon City, Colorado, 81212. Click subscribe to like bell, subscribe to our YouTube channel, click the like button, click the notification bell, our digital business cards, and also our hashtags. I appreciate you guys being here on a Sunday. I thought it would be a good day to get it out, but Yeshua already had told me I'm going to do a video today. So when he woke me up this morning with James 4. Guys, have a wonderful, wonderful day. I'm going to go ahead and let him close out with prayer. I told you it won't be quite as long today. It's an hour and 25 minutes or more, but we're going to go ahead and close out. I didn't even know. I think I have my little trumpet person on the screen today, because we are really waiting on the trumpet to sound. And while we're waiting, we need to be getting ready, making sure our sins won't find us out, giving our life to Yeshua, repenting every day, getting close to him every night, every day, and giving up this world, because this world has gone away. Babylon has fallen. Oh, absolutely, guys. So go ahead and close out if you like.
Heavenly Father, we do thank you for everyone who gets to view the video. We thank you for the video. Father, we thank you for all our contributors and our prayer partners, Father. We love you so much. We thank you for Yeshua. We thank you for what you're doing around the world with all your missionaries. We love our missionaries, Father. We pray for them every day. And Father, we pray for all your missionaries and all your support groups and all your sending agencies you have out there and all your Bible translators. You got all these mercy ships and all these things all over the planet, Father, helping people and leading people into your kingdom. Come and set up your kingdom on the planet, Father, in Yeshua's name. Amen.
Amen. We love you guys. We thank you so much. If you want prayer anytime, write us on emails, okay? Because a lot of we put the prayer lines out. And speaking of prayer lines, we are praying. I think a lot of the prayer requests have been coming in, and God is answering prayer. So we'll talk more about that on the next video, but I really want you guys to know I love you so much, and I'll see you guys in another video, and you guys have a wonderful, blessed Sunday night. Love you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.